Hi, I'm Stu. Welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today we're going to be doing a bit of a deep dive on audio. Now, if you've been with the channel for a while, you'll know my audio started out not sounding so great, and sometimes I could be accused of it being a little bit on the quiet side. That's because I was mainly using these guys, the Apple headphones. I did upgrade to the Apple AirPods at one point, but they only record in mono, so they don't sound so good either. They're good at a pinch. If you want to have a cheeky little lav mic that you can just use on the fly, they are not great for optimum audio recording. Now, I'm recording audio in two ways just now. I'm recording onto my iPhone 11, which is filming just now, and I'm also recording audio onto the iPhone 12, which is in front of me, hence the little clamp. And I found that recording audio this way and using a single clap to basically sync the audio in LumaFusion at a later stage seems to be the best way to get the best recording. But the reason I'm saying that is obviously I do an awful lot of screen recording in that, and when it comes to screen recording, that is not actually the best option for capturing sound. It doesn't seem to use the full capabilities of all the mics on the iPad. And that's why we're going to look at some different options in terms of screen recording, recording with third party app, and also recording externally. Let's see how we go and start this deep dive of getting really good audio with your iPad and your iPhone. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so, and ring the bell so you get notified when the next video tutorial is uploaded. So let's get started. And there we go. So, the purposes of this video tutorial has been twofold. One, it's to show you guys how to get the best audio possible out of the gear you have with you, which generally speaking is going to be your iPhone, your iPad, and maybe your Apple headphones or AirPods, that kind of thing. So we're juggling and doing testing between those. Now, I've actually got an accompanying video that will let you see about six different examples where I record mono audio and stereo from the two built-in mics in the phone themselves. And I go through different apps from Ferrite Pro right the way back to the Apple Voice Memos. So it gives you a wide choice to look at in terms of audio testing, and you can decide for yourself which one you like the best. The purpose of this video tutorial is to take that information and distill it down into getting the best audio. So the first thing I'm going to teach you is how to manually sync up audio, because that's important. Okay, so I'm doing a screen recording just to show you the iPhone 11 Pro Max side of things. So I've just recorded a piece to the iPad Air effectively, and what I want to do is get the audio across to the iPad Air. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a dual screen recording. I'm going to switch on screen recording on the iPad Air now as well, and we'll just do a wee sync clap. Make sure everything's lined up. This is kind of a bit of an inception thing of I am showing you how to do audio whilst doing audio. In Ferrite Pro, we want to tap on the info button. That gives us the naming convention. And from here, I'm going to do, I'm going to call this manual sync or manual audio sync, just so that I know what this relates to. There we go. Tap done. And then you'll see that comes into your drop and open with where we're going to go for LumaFusion. And then that comes into the list, which I'm going to change to these thumbnails. And that's it. So just tap done. Okay, so just to show you what we've got here, we've got our video clip, we've got the scratch audio from the video clip, and we've got our main audio from the iPhone 11 Pro Max using the Ferrite Pro app. So we've got two sync points that we need to marry up. Right, so how do we go about lining these up? What I first tend to do though is actually zoom out a little bit, and that then just gives you a tiny little bit more sort of peak pointedness on the actual waveform. And then what we want to do is just grab our iPhone 11 audio and get it as close as we can and see how close we are to lining up. Now, I would think that the peak on the iPhone 11 audio is slightly behind the scratch audio, but we won't know that until we zoom in. When it comes to actually doing this and manually syncing your audio, I would say this is the video editing equivalent to using autofocus and manually focusing. So if you've been used to the likes of Final Cut or Premiere Pro, you've had the ability to match audio automatically for years now, and it's a feature that I think will come to LumaFusion eventually, but at the moment you've got to do it manually, and it's something you should be comfortable doing and not have any anxiety over if for some reason you are working with audio and being able to manually sync to get everything lined up. So I'm just going to move everything forward a little bit, see how we're doing, just a little bit more. Chances are, by the way this grabs the frame, you want to get the peaks just about perfect and the little troughs just about perfect. Now, you will end up with the iPhone 11 or your external audio slightly ahead of the scratch audio. That's okay. It actually works out really, really well. So now that we've got a good position, we'll just play it through. And you'll see the audio is pretty much combined. So what we have to do now is switch off our scratch audio, and I'm also going to trim up the clip. So go to about here, Command B, get rid of everything before, and there we have, as you can see, perfectly aligned audio. That's where you want to be, and the more you zoom out, the more you'll see the waveforms match exactly. There you go. So that is how you align audio manually using an external recorder. In this case, I've used my iPhone 11, but obviously this could be any external recording device.
In part two, we're going to look at all the different settings you would use for working with the iPhone, a basic cheap lav mic, and also the Apple headphones. And we'll also be using a plugin which will help take away any hums and hisses in the background of the audio. I'll catch you on the next one. See you later.
If you like the video, then give it a thumbs up, as it really helps the channel. Don't forget to subscribe for more video tutorials every week, and ring the bell to get notified of when Stu has uploaded a new video tutorial. You have been watching I Am Stu. See you later.